This is me, June 19th, and this is also me, August 14th. Here I am studying for my finals, and here I am shooting a short film. So how do I balance everything?
Hey guys, it's Kay and welcome to my channel. I recently asked you guys what FAQ I should answer and you guys chose how to balance studying and what I love. So today I am here to answer that question for you. If you also want to contribute to my future videos, make sure you subscribe to my channel and follow me on Instagram so you can join the fam and not miss any notifications. A quick shout out to Ana Luisa, they have amazing jewelry and you can get a 10% discount by using a secret code. More details in my previous video, all links in the description. For most of my life, I was surrounded with people that thought studying was their number one priority. Okay, let me clarify, studying wasn't their priority, getting good grades were. And I was that rebellious teen that tried so hard to prove they were wrong. And I am here to proudly tell you guys, you can balance everything. I fell in love with filmmaking freshman year of high school when I joined the school filmmaking club. Ever since, I have participated in 5 student short films so far, including the one that I made this year. Filmmaking is a lot of work. Though all of the films that I made so far were shot during the summer, it took months of preparation beforehand. And some people that don't really know the art of filmmaking think that the shooting days are the only days of work, but that's not true. Before the actual shoot, you need to finish the script, the storyboarding, the casting, the location hunting, the prop design, equipment rentals. The list just goes on and on. And whether I was in high school or in college, balancing that with my school work and everything else was really difficult. And actually, it kind of took 3 years for me to figure out how to get everything done. I wouldn't say I'm an expert now because I still struggle sometimes, but believe me, follow these tips and you will save a heap of time.
1. Set your priorities.
Now, if you two don't mind, I'm going to bed before either of you come up with another clever idea to get us killed. Or worse, expelled.
She needs to sort out her priorities.
One of my favorite quotes from the Harry Potter series. Oh yes, Hermione needs to set out her priorities and so do we. I'm someone that believes that you should always follow your heart and do what you're truly passionate about, but I wasn't able to be that rebellious and do everything that I wanted whenever I wanted. I was always that shy kid in school, so I had to find my own way to get things done. So anyways, if it's exam period, of course, exam prep is your number one priority. So focus on your studying, and if you become easily distracted, dedicate yourself 20 to 30 minutes so that you can take a break and do what you gotta do. For me, I love drawing and art, and to relate that to filmmaking, storyboarding, and designing props was something that I really loved. So every time I was on a break, I would do that. And when exams are over, studying is no longer your priority. When you're in school, the school system cycles so fast. For me, it's like midterm final, and I feel like I'm this hamster that's stuck on a wheel that just can't get off. But that's because I'm preoccupied with my tests and grades even when I don't have to worry about them. Depending on your situation and your time in life, you probably have different stuff that's going on that you want to focus on. So make sure you know that you know what's important in that moment so you don't waste time stressing, thinking other things that you need or want to do.
2. Avoid feeling guilt and be confident in your decisions.
Mom, I have to tell you something. I've decided that I'm not going back to Yale next year. I'm not sure that it's the right place for me.
You've known what you wanted to do with your life since you were 3. Be a journalist.
Maybe not.
If we could stretch time infinitely, we would be able to do everything. You guys probably wouldn't have even clicked on this video because the question itself is silly. But because time is limited, and it feels like we have so much to do all the time, we start stressing. And then balancing things on our schedule seems almost impossible. But viewing it from a positive perspective, I think it can be a motive to push us to do what we do. Because we know that time is limited, we push ourselves to search for what we love and do those things. One thing that I regret about my past time management is the feeling of guilt. Especially in high school when I was spending so much time watching a bunch of crash courses about filmmaking on YouTube, I felt the guilt that my time wasn't being spent wisely, like preparing for exams, mostly because, to quote my high school teacher, "You can do all that stuff after you graduate, in college, so focus on your grades right now. But even when I suppressed my artistic desires and forced myself to study, I felt so ashamed of myself and I was not determined enough to follow my true dreams. But looking back, I feel like a lot of the time was actually wasted on the guilt that I was feeling. If I had been a bit more confident in my decisions when I was focusing a bit more on studying or I was doing some activities that expressed my creative side, I feel like a lot of the time would have been saved from feeling sorry for myself and being angry at the system, blaming it on society. In reality, it was my mindset that had to be fixed.
You've got to find what you love, and that is as true for work as it is for your lovers. Your work is going to fill a large part of your life, and the only way to be truly satisfied is to do what you believe is great work. And the only way to do great work is to love what you do. If you haven't found it yet, keep looking and don't settle.
Whatever you do, whether that be studying or anything else, I hope you guys do it with a purpose and you enjoy the process. Do what you love and love what you do. The most realistic tip of the day, get yourself a planner and start planning. For everyone that asked me the question, how do you balance your studying and everything else? You probably are struggling with this problem because you have a lot of things that you want to do. You want to ace in everything. Well, I love that mindset, so keep it up. And a planner will really help you on the way. I have been writing a planner slash diary slash journal, whatever you want to call it, for the past 5 years. I could probably make a new video just doing a flip through of these. So the trick is simple. Writing down everything helps me stay more organized with my schedule so that I know what I'm doing whenever I'm doing it. So invest in one of these.